Welcome back. I'm excited that you're here. On this video, I'm going to be using Tracy Reed's latest collection, Hearth and Hollow, and I'm excited to do a few different projects with it. One of the projects is going to be a journal spread. I'll do one for the week of, I gotta skip a page, but I'll do one for the start of the next week, so the 8th, and I'll just do a full page spread or just maybe a few daily pages, whatever I feel like. Right here, I cut out all of her stickers. It's a lot of beautiful stickers. There is a home with a tree. There's a lot of cross-stitch embroidery hoops, which I love. And there's in the kit, she has a lot of tags, and the animals come in these tags. I can't see me loving no bunny but you, so they have a lot of great puns. I love my pack. Every family has a few nuts, just the season to hibernate. There's also some sweaters, squash, some leaves. There's just a wide variety of die cuts that she has in here, and I'm excited to kind of pick out some to document November, because the main project that I'm gonna do is start on my family's October and November storyline chapter. If you remember, I decided to try out storyline chapters for my project life last year, starting in March. I finished March through May, and I did a walkthrough of that. I'll leave that up in the eye. But I finished that, and I kind of skipped over summer, and now I'm working in October and November. With these storyline chapters, for me, just the way that I work, I have to plan out every single page. So it took me a while to plan out October, but this is gonna be October right here. And then I think the rest will be November. And I don't think I'll do December since I have December daily. So for the November opening, I just did 2.75 by 3.75. And I just did 4 of the journaling cards and then 4 pictures to start off my family's November. And so I'll just stagger them. And then the next page is going to be a really fun collage design that I came up with using the kit. And I'll put in the middle this traveler's notebook right here. That way I can add in a ton more journaling. So I made the template, like I said, and if you guys want that, I will leave it as a download. Great, that was a long introduction, but I wanted you to see what I was making and to kind of see Tracy's kit. There's a ton more with Tracy's kit, only the stickers that I cut out with my Cameo. There's journaling cards and papers and the traveler's notebook papers. There's just a lot in this beautiful kit, so I will leave a link to that kit, and I'm gonna go ahead and get started on my projects. Okay, so I'm gonna start laying out the photos. I'm actually gonna pull it up in my Photoshop Elements, and then that way I can see how I laid it out in Photoshop Elements. I just picked a few photos that I really liked from the month and kind of represented the month as a whole, and just used those, and then printed out some journaling cards. And then I have a happy list where I wrote family time, collecting leaves and going on fall walks, friends, adventures in nature, and then backyard fun. So I just wrote a little snapshot of the month, and then I will add that down to the bottom of the tree. And then for the other side, I'm gonna get out my ruler and make sure that the photo with my daughter and I matches the plaid-ish paper. Is that what it's called? The striped paper on the far left. And then I'll use the gratitude card as well. And then a photo of my daughter and I baking. And this is where the fun comes in. I have that whole big tray of die cuts and little pieces, so I'm just gonna have fun digging through all of those and figuring out how I want to make my clusters. I know I'm gonna make a small one over there on the far left, and I'm gonna make one down in the bottom of the right page, so the bottom left of the right page. And I will include a little basket of pumpkins and gourds. And since I included that, I'm gonna put a pumpkin and gourd die cut on the left side. And I couldn't resist using a tree and also the mushroom die cut that says so much, I love you so much. And I love Tracy's puns. They're so funny. And so I had to include that. And then I'm just sprinkling the leaves and then adding in a few hearts as well. And then the gratitude will have just a green leaf. And I'll add a title later on to the page as well. Okay, so this is the second project I decided to include in this process video. I am going to take a design from April Orr, Mom Run Craft. She makes the most incredible planner pages. I just love what she does. And she made a new design where she included kind of like a sidebar or just a big block, which is kind of what I drew right here. So that way she could keep track of her kids' activities and kind of a central point for the week. And then the right-hand side will start the daily pages. So that is what I'm going to attempt. I'm going to attempt to planner scrap lift April, and I'm very excited because, like I said, I just love her style. So I'm drawing three boxes on the right-hand side because those are going to be kind of what my different sections are. And then I'm going to break up this large box on the left into two columns and then five rows for the 5 days of the week for my two different kids. And then I'll have a bottom section for the weekend. And that way I can put in their soccer games. And I will get out some Everyday Explorer stamps to add in the Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. And I'll just use the first letter of the day. And then I will just begin to build some clusters, once again using that big tray of stickers. And I'm sticking with lots of florals up at the top and then a few leaves. I also bravely, very bravely to me, wrote out the numbers 8, 14 for both sides. April has amazing handwriting as well, and I just wanted to attempt it. I'm not too happy with the 8 on the left side, but you know what? I tried it. I was brave. I did it. And I'll add in the week number later on, once I figure out what that week number is for this coming week. And then the three sections are going to be home stuff, gratitude, and creative to-dos. And then the bottom left has a really great quote, and then I'm just adding in some florals and tucking them in. The nice part with the florals is that when they hang off the page and then you trim off that little section, you can always use that little bit of floral somewhere else at some point. And I also did like April, and I stamped the Monday right in the middle of the 8. Not sure if it looks great, but you know what, you guys, I really love how this whole layout turned out, and I really liked having just a central section for my kids and what they are going to do. And I'm just really enjoying daily pages lately for journaling and just having all my thoughts for the day down on one page, so that's been really nice. So I'm stamping the days of the week, and then I will add my kids' names up at the top, B&B, and I'm just gonna finish up putting some more florals on the page. I want to put a little something down in the bottom right because I felt like it was a little naked, for lack of a better word. So I cut some florals and I just made a small border of florals down at the bottom. And I love how Tracy included some acorns in the florals. Those are perfect. And then the word strip I chose are "These days are precious." And then I'm just making a very simple cluster right above the week number, and that's gonna be Harvest Love, and then I brought in another embroidery hoop and just a leaf. So a small little cluster since that's not a main cluster. So there you go. I'm gonna stop it here. Two projects for this video and this kit, and I hope you guys have enjoyed watching this video. I would love a thumbs up or a subscribe if you are new to my channel. Thanks so much and have a great day. Bye.